Hello, wonderful people. My name is Carol Vey and welcome back to my channel. Many of you know that I recently retired from my full-time career, which is awesome and amazing. But so many people are asking me what I plan to do in retirement. And one lady recently asked me, and I mentioned that I have a YouTube ministry about Jesus. She answered and said that that was awesome as long as I wasn't saying that Jesus was the only way and not giving other religions all the same opportunity. I responded that what I was doing is exactly what she said, is saying that Jesus is Lord and that He is the only way. He is the way, the truth, and the life, and the Bible talks about that all the way through. I think that this idea, saying that Jesus is the only way of salvation, is one of the reasons that the world has such a hard time accepting the idea, along with the fact that we have to realize that we are sinners in need of a savior, which is also hard for a lot of people to come to terms with. Another interesting thing I notice when I talk about Jesus is that some people will say that they believe in Jesus and they believe in Islam and Buddha and all of these other religions because they want to be so all accepting. But the funny thing about that is that each one of those different religions believes that they also are the only way. So in other words, there's really no way to be politically correct when you're talking about religion. Well, this got me to thinking that many people must think I'm narrow-minded, and I actually looked that up in the dictionary. And it says, not willing to listen or tolerate other people's views. And it also said prejudiced. And that even made me think, well, maybe I'm not even narrow-minded. Maybe I'm close-minded. And that means having a mind firmly unreceptive to new ideas or arguments. And that's exactly where I am with the Lord, since He never changes. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And His word proves that He is the Lord God who created us. I will continue to say that Jesus is the only way to salvation. Jesus even asked His disciples this important question. When Jesus came into the region of Caesarea Philippi, He asked His disciples, saying, "Who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?" So they said, "Some say John the Baptist, some say Elijah, and others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered and said, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus answered and said to him, "Blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven." Understanding the deity of Jesus is fundamental in even defending the Christian faith, because there are so many false teachings that reduce Jesus to something like a prophet or an archangel or something like that. But all the way through, the Bible says that Jesus is God. 1 John 2:23 says, "Whoever denies the Son does not have the Father either. He who acknowledges the Son has the Father also." And in John 5:23 it says that all should honor the Son just as they honor the Father. He who does not honor the Son does not honor the Father who sent Him. So a lot of these false teachings will honor the Father but not the Son. The Bible teaches that there is only one true God. Deuteronomy 6:4 says, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one." The God of the Bible is the one and only. 1 Corinthians 8:6 says, "Yet for us there is one God, the Father of whom are all things, and we for Him, and one Lord, Jesus Christ, through whom are all things, and through whom we live." This verse is saying that there is only one God, the Father that everything comes from, and He wants us to live for Him, and also there is only one Master, Jesus Christ our Lord. John 1, 1 through 3 says, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through Him, and without Him nothing was made that was made." And here's that the word again, through, where we heard them talking about everything was through Jesus. In Romans chapter 9, the Apostle Paul was talking about Israel's rejection of Christ. And I think he was even saying, "I wish I could trade places with these unbelievers so that they could experience this wonderful salvation." Romans 9:5 says, "Of whom are the fathers, and from whom, according to the flesh, Christ came, who is over all, the eternally blessed God." Amen. Do you guys remember the story of Ananias and Sapphira at the end of Acts chapter 4, where all the believers were selling their stuff and bringing their money together to help each other? And these two actually lied to the Holy Spirit. And it says in Acts chapter 5, "But Peter said, Ananias, why has Satan filled your heart to lie to the Holy Spirit and keep back part of the price of the land for yourself? While it remained, was it not your own? And after it was sold, was it not in your own control? Why have you conceived this thing in your heart? You have not lied to men, but to God." So because they were lying to the Holy Spirit here, the word says that they were lying to God. Each part of the Trinity is its distinct person, but it's all still the same one true God. We talked earlier about the book of John, where the Word was God. And further down in verse 14, it says, "And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld His glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth." So this Word that we were told is God became flesh. So the one true God is fully God and fully man. The Bible teaches that Jesus pre-existed before the world was even created. In Genesis 1:1, it says, "In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth." And when we put this verse together with John 1:1, we realize that this is Jesus. John 17, verses 3 through 5 say, "And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I have glorified you on the earth. I have finished the work which you have given me to do. And now, O Father, glorify me together with yourself, with the glory which I had with you before the world was." Jesus refers to his pre-existence, and the words that he uses prove his deity. Some of my favorite scripture is found in John 14, when Jesus is telling his disciples not to be troubled, that he is going to prepare a place for them, and that where he is, there they will be also, and he'll come back and bring them to where he is. A little further down, Thomas asks Jesus where he's going and how he can know the way. And Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you had known me, you would have known my Father also. And from now on, you know him and have seen him." When Paul wrote his letter to the Philippians, he said, "Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, taking the form of a bondservant and coming in the likeness of men, and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on the cross," which is probably the worst way you could think up to die. But the Father loves us so much that he had a plan to bring us to himself. and that invitation is available to anyone. But whether we accept or not is completely up to us. We have a free will. A little further down in the same chapter, Paul says that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, of those in heaven and those on earth and of those under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Listen to how this verse from Isaiah sounds so similar. I have sworn by myself, the word has gone out of my mouth in righteousness and shall not return, that to me every knee shall bow, every tongue shall take an oath. Jesus is our creator. Colossians 1:16 says, for by him all things were created that are in heaven and that are on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created through him and for him. Hebrews chapter 1 verse 2 says, has in these last days spoken to us by his Son, whom he has appointed heir of all things, through whom also he made the worlds. Within Jesus is the fullness of the Godhead, which allows him to create all things. Colossians 2:9 says, for in him dwells all the fullness of the Godhead bodily. And the Greek word for Godhead here, I hope I can pronounce it right, is theotes, and it refers to the state of being God. Jesus identifies himself as being divine. John 8:23 and 24 says, and he said to them, you are from beneath and I am from above. You are of this world, I am not of this world. Therefore, I said to you that you will die in your sins, for if you do not believe that I am he, you will die in your sins. And I love this verse because it says, if you do not believe that I am he, that's all it takes, is believing that Jesus is God and that he came to earth to die on the cross for our sins. In John chapter 8, the Jewish leaders were asking Jesus who he was. Jesus said to them, most assuredly, I say to you, before Abraham was, I am. And that's two things that should hit close to home with the Jewish people, because they know exactly who Abraham is, and they also know who I am, all in caps, is. This I am statement can also be found in Isaiah chapter 43, where it says, you are my witnesses, said the Lord, and my servant whom I have chosen, that you may know and believe me and understand that I am he. Before me there was no God formed, nor shall there be after me. I, even I, am the Lord, and besides me there is no Savior. Jesus is God. John 13:19 says, now I tell you before it comes, that when it does come to pass, you may believe that I am he. The apostles identified Jesus as God. 2 Peter 1:1 calls God our Savior. Simon Peter, a bondservant and apostle of Jesus Christ, to those who have obtained like precious faith with us by the righteousness of our God and Savior, Jesus Christ. And one of my favorites, Titus 2:13, which says, looking for the blessed hope and glorious appearing of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. And the Apostle John also called Jesus the Alpha and Omega and the first and the last. In Revelation 22, it says, I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Finally, Jesus made many claims that no human could ever make. Jesus Christ not only identifies as God, but shows his deity through his words and actions. Romans 10:9 says that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. we must believe that Jesus is Lord to have everlasting life and enter into heaven. Matthew 7:21 says, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' shall enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father in heaven." And a lot of people might say, well, the will is to do, you know, go to church and do all this. The will of his Father is to believe in the one that was sent. Our relationship with the Lord is just that. It's a personal relationship, and we communicate directly with him. Matthew 28:18 says, "And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, 'All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth.'" And this is something that no other human could claim, not even Moses or anybody in the Bible other than God himself. One of the reasons I was studying the Bible all those years ago to prove that the whole Bible was false is because there was a false religion talking to me at the time and meeting with me and listening to what I was saying, and my Christian friends knew about it and they confronted me with the truth of the Bible. And so that's why I went on a Bible study spree of my own to prove the Bible wrong. And that one night when the words of the Bible jumped out and proved that they were real, and I felt the presence of the Holy Spirit, I have been changed. And today it's on my heart because these big organizations have taken this Word of God, the Holy Bible, and made it into their own format, reducing the deity of Christ down to a special man or prophet or archangel. But that's not what the Bible teaches. The Bible teaches about one true God who loved us so much that he made a way for us to be with him by coming to earth as a man and shedding his own blood to pay for our sins so that we could be with him forever. That's the God I love. That's the God that I want to follow. And that's the God that I am here defending week after week, because he loves us, he loves you, and he is God. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we do give you all the praise and honor and glory today because you are the one true God of the Bible, Lord. And I thank you every day that you gave us your word, you gave us your holy scripture, your God-breathed scripture that we could learn from, Lord God. And you teach us that your Son has been given all authority on heaven and earth. And so today we just give you all of the praise and honor, Lord God, because you are so worthy and deserving of it all. And Lord, I pray for my listeners today, every single one of them, no matter what they're going through, Lord God. There are so many seasons in our personal lives, and when added to what's already going on in the world, it could seem overwhelming. So Lord, I pray that you pour your comfort out right now, your peace and comfort, in a tangible way that they can feel, Lord God. And if any of them needs any type of healing, whether physical or emotional, Lord, I pray that you meet that need right now in Jesus' name, that you completely cover them in your protection. And Lord, we also give you praise for all of the answered prayers that are represented here, Lord God. You're so amazing, and we just put you first today and always, and we pray all of this in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. And thank you guys again for tuning in today. I really do love and appreciate you guys more than you know. And if you have been watching for a while and have never subscribed, or you're brand new to this channel and you feel led to hit the subscribe button, that would be so awesome. And if you enjoyed this video, please consider giving it a thumbs up. And as always, please leave any questions or comments that you might have. And I will continue to pray for you as we go into this new week. So take care and God bless you.